So today, let's go over some more details for the new MacBook Pro 14-inch model. Today we've had a report showing us a feature finally upgraded inside the new MacBook Pro after 10 years. Let's go more into details about this upgraded feature and also a summary of everything we know so far, including the MacBook Pro 14-inch release date and price. So fall is approaching, and that can only mean new MacBooks are coming very soon. So, going forward, I've decided for all the new MacBook Pro 14-inch videos, like this one you are watching, I'm going to give you the latest details on specific reports of info that we've been told, then details of the planned release date time, then a summary of the models that are going to be released with all their features that we've learnt in previous leaks. After, I'm going to reveal my wish list, as it were, for the MacBook Pro 14-inch, and also put in the comments below of what features you would like to see in the new MacBook Pros, and maybe in my next video, I may feature your comment and discuss my thoughts around it. So let's get started with that feature that is finally being upgraded. So funny enough, one feature that is on MacBook Pros that hasn't been changed officially since 2011 is the MacBook Pro's webcam. The webcam still records at 720p after all this time. Yes, back in 2020 with the new M1 chipsets and the webcams inside those MacBooks, they had the neural engine inside it and it actually improved kind of the picture quality on those MacBook Pros, but yet the resolution was still 720p. The good news is, we've had a report where this feature is finally getting the upgrade it deserves. According to Dylan, the MacBook Pro 14-inch and 16-inch will get the same 1080p camera we now find inside the iMac 24-inch model that came out earlier this year. As silly as it sounds, I'm quite excited about this, as it's way overdue to be upgraded. But one feature I am really excited about compared to a normal 1080p camera is that this one will have the M1X chipset behind it with a really powerful neural engine to make videos and streaming quality even clearer than an off-the-shelf webcam. Also the fact that it's likely to have that new center stage feature. However, I will comment that this also leads me on to say that all reports and leaks are not 100% proof that they will come true for new MacBooks. Like I said at the beginning of this video, I can only present to you what I've been told and shown. However, if you are still watching this video, then you're as curious as I am in knowing what is being said about the new MacBooks anyway. So, release date is next. So it's very likely that the new MacBook Pros are coming this fall, but when specifically is the big question. Now, a new leak has come from DigiTimes with their claim that the MacBooks will be announced in September this year. But right away, I'm jumping right in there. September, apart from the exception of last year due to COVID, like again, is a big exception. Normally September time, an event what happens then is for the Apple Watches and most importantly, iPhones. So for Apple to bring this out at that time would be very strange. However, it does say that Apple will announce the MacBooks, and to be honest, in the last years, we have had many of Apple's products announced and not launched to about 3 or 4 weeks later, so this would fall into October territory. Remember, the last time we got an overall design refresh on the MacBook Pros was in October 2016, so there's a possibility for this. But the exact date, with the exception of the COVID launches in 2020 of the new M1 Max, all previous full releases of MacBooks have come at the end of October, and this has always been in the mid-20 numbers or even the first or second day into November, and it's always been a Friday. In fact, another leaker, Dylan, has also said that the end of October or early November time is on the cards. So based on this info, and remember this is on facts of other full-time MacBook releases, so remember this is not written in stone, we could, and I'll say that again, could see the new MacBooks in our hands on October 22nd or October 29th. But if we get a firm date, this of course will change, but for now this gives you a good time to base on when the release will be. So just quickly, this channel has just hit over 230,000 subscribers, which is absolutely amazing. And we did a giveaway of a MacBook Pro M1. Well, I've got you some great news, guys. We're doing another giveaway, and it is for this. It is for an iPad Pro M1 with 8GB of RAM and 256GB of storage. Now, anybody can enter in to win this giveaway around the world. It is an international giveaway. But all I want to know from you guys is basically, what Apple tech are you planning to buy in 2021? Or what other tech are you planning to buy if it's not going to be Apple tech? Write it down in the comments below, and make sure at the same time as well to subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell, because when we get over 260,000 subscribers, I'm going to be revealing who the winner is of this iPad Pro. So make sure you do that right now, because you'll want to know if you're going to be the lucky person to get your hands on this iPad Pro. Also at the same time as well, if you're enjoying this video so far, please make sure to press the like button. Well, let's get back to the video. With the latest leaks and release date out of the way, let's move on to a summary of everything we know so far. That previous leaks have painted a picture of the details for the MacBook Pro 14-inch with its price as well. So it's possible that what you're seeing here is going to change over the next coming weeks or months as we get more leaks and reports coming in. But let's begin. So the new MacBook Pro 14-inch is most likely going to be getting that brand new XDR liquid retina display like what we get inside the iPad Pro right now. It will be a mini LED display, and with that we'll be getting a resolution of around 2752 by 1720. And also, if it's like the XDR liquid retina display that exists right now, like in the iPad Pro 12.9 inch, it will also come with a ProMotion display, what means it will have a 120 hertz refresh rate. For storage options, it will start at 512 gigabytes and go all the way up to 4 terabytes. For the actual chipset inside it, it is looking likely that we're probably going to be getting an M1X chipset inside, and this will be a 10 core CPU setup, and this will give us 8 performance cores and 2 efficiency cores, and then there will be an option between a 16 and a 32 core GPU depending on how much RAM you pick. And talking about RAM, there's going to be a choice between 16 to 64 gigabytes of RAM, and it's seeming likely that if you do pick the 32 gigabytes or the 64 gigabyte RAM option, this will give you the 32 core GPU option. There's also going to be a brand new design, because at the end of the day we're increasing up to a 14-inch design, and it's all going to look completely different. We're going to have an aluminium body, what MacBook Pros have been made out for many years. For ports wise, we're going to be getting the MagSafe. It's going to be returning at last in a brand new way, so it's really exciting to see to come back to the MacBook Pros, because it's a great port. We're also going to be getting 3 USB-C Thunderbolt 4 ports will also be USB 4 compatible, and we're also going to be getting return of a HDMI port, will be HDMI 2.1, and also an SD card port as well. That's going to be returning back to the MacBook Pro. For the actual webcam, we're going to be getting that center stage webcam like we get on the new iPad Pros right now, and this is a 12 megapixel camera in the middle of your MacBook Pro. For battery life, we're expected to be getting a 6,068 milliamp battery inside it, so that should give us a really good battery life, especially mixed with the brand new Apple Silicon chipset. So prices wise, these are based on the lowest spec MacBook Pro 14-inch that you can get, because you can choose the different kind of storage options and RAMs and bits and pieces. All the prices sort of change. So I've just basically based all the prices on 16 gigs of RAM and then going up with the storages. So starting with the 512 gigabyte of storage, it will start at $1,799. 1 terabyte will be $1,999. 2 terabytes at $2,399, and 4 terabytes at $2,999. So that is a summary of the MacBook Pro 14-inch. However, for my thoughts and wishes. So my main wish is basically the same for the 16-inch MacBook Pro, and it's to do with the actual price. Now, over the years, the 13-inch MacBook Pro, so this is what we've got right now, including the higher tier version of the 13-inch model, has gone up and creeped up in price quite a bit. The higher tier 13-inch model right now, what they still sell from Apple, starts at $1,800. And if we go back about 8 years ago or so, it starts at $1,400. And I'm just hoping that Apple can at least keep the same price this year round for this brand new MacBook Pro and not increase the price for this next generation. But let me know in your thoughts below if you agree with this or not, and write in the comments as well what your wishes would be for the new MacBook Pro 14-inch. Well guys, it's also time to wrap up this video, so if you've enjoyed watching it, please make sure to like the video, and at the same time, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews, and comparisons, please make sure to hit the subscribe button, followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys, see you soon.